My newsmaker tonight, Jackson Mthembu, the minister in the presidency, has kindly agreed to visit us tonight. Good evening to you, Minister.
Evening, my friend.
It's good to see you, and congratulations. I haven't seen you since you were appointed minister.
No, thank you very much,
from
JJ.
From chief whip to minister, quite a leap there. And interestingly, some of the themes carry on, right?
Yeah.
The ascension of the president 18 months or so ago into the presidency, right, was pinned on clean governance.
Yep.
Was pinned on, you know, a new leaf. Even today, as you were speaking, you emphasized some of the things that has happened to try and underpin,
yeah,
you know, that kind of approach. Do you think that there are a few things that are making that dream difficult? A lot of people don't understand why he agonized so much about creating a cabinet that excluded certain people who society was questioning, right? And then default on having some parliamentary appointments that seem to reverse that kind of perception of fighting of corruption. Just give me an overall sense of how you see, this framework of clean governance beginning to settle into the presidency of Ramaphosa.
Well, you are correct. When it comes to the cabinet and the people that the president appointed into the cabinet, as you will know, is the president's prerogative to appoint and disappoint people in the executive.
Mm.
So on that score, the president had all the authority.
Yes.
Including interacting with the top six.
Mm.
He could put his foot down and say, you know, these are the types of people I would like to work with, who fit into this new dawn, which all of us believe in. If we are to move South Africa forward, we need, first of all, to convince people in our country that we have turned a new leaf. We need to convince people in our country that, indeed, we have self-introspected, particularly as it relates to people that you put to lead in government.
Yes.
Now, you have asked me a very interesting question. Chairs of committees.
Mm.
First of all, you will know, JJ, now, when a person is appointed to be a member of parliament, the person goes through what you call your integrity commission, the ANC body that looks whether all of us carry the necessary appeal,
yes,
to be MPs. You go through that committee, you pass, as we have passed. You go through the IEC itself. As you will know, when people, when all parties publicize their lists of people that they will be sending to parliament, the IEC then gazetted those lists and invited people in South Africa to say, if you know that Mthembu does not qualify to go to parliament, say so, assist us as the commission responsible for taking people to parliament, of course, even though the people come from parties, assist us. Now, the members of parliament that are there now have passed through first the ANC's own internal mechanism.
Yeah.
Secondly, they've passed through the IEC. Nobody went to the IEC and said, this member and this member and this member do not qualify for these very genuine reasons. And of course, also the IEC was also of the same view. No, it didn't happen. Now, would you then say that here are people who have passed the test of becoming MPs?
Yeah.
All of a sudden, you then bring a very, very subjective view of JJ Thabane. that says this one, even though they have
passed there,
they've passed the internal mechanism,
yeah.
They've passed the ISC scrutiny, but they must just remain, because that's your thinking.
Yeah.
They must remain just as members, because that's what they've passed to do. They can't be anything else in the scheme and architecture of parliament. They can't be chairpersons of committees. They can't be whips. They can't be house chairs. They can't be speakers, because if all those are elected by parliament itself, the president only deals with the executive.
Yeah.
Now, I think you'll be wrong.
All right, let me come in there.
You will be wrong.
Right, let me come in there. I didn't think you will spiritedly, right, defend that one. I thought you were going to wash your hands and say the president is not his prerogative, there are other people. But since you have decided to venture to defend it, let's deal with it.
I'm not defending it, I'm putting facts.
It sounds that you are defending it because you don't see anything wrong with somebody like Bongo. You are a chief whip. Bongo tried to bribe a leader, an evidence leader of ESCOM. He's still to appear before the ethics committee of parliament. Doesn't matter, it was the fifth parliament. He has not appeared in there before that committee. He can't possibly just be cleared because of all the things you are describing, right? Museveni usually lied about what was said in cabinet, and it was reported in parliament. A member of the executive, in this case, your predecessor minister in the presidency, or Jeff Hadebe at that point, contradicted him to say this was wrong, right? So there are things that happen in parliament that parliament was supposed to deal with firmly about certain members and not promote those people before those things are dealt with. And I think that all I'm dealing with here is perceptions, that people are seeing the fact that Ramaphosa definitely, without doubt, even though it was his prerogative, he had to consult the top six. He had to consult COSATU. He had to consult the alliance, right? Now you are telling me that the top six, that is in charge of caucus, right? Then suddenly he doesn't have a say. He's the president who doesn't have a say on how you are going to look like when you have a Bongo who's a clear liar, right? Who then to bribe somebody, as somebody who lied about what was discussed in cabinet. He's now going to represent this new dawn in parliament, unless a new dawn only applies to the executive. I'm just saying that I'm dealing here with perceptions, and you need to agree with me that it doesn't look good right now.
No. You see, what I've... Maybe I should have taken the route that you are asking me that I should have taken. Mm. Maybe I should have said, no, it's a matter of parliament. But if I said it's a matter of parliament having just been a chief whip, I don't think that I've been honest with you and your listeners. The fact of the matter, with everything you have said, those members went through the ANC, NEC, and its integrity commission.
Yeah.
Now, secondly, they went through the IEC. I'll repeat that again.
Yeah.
They went through the IEC.
And none of you objected, whereas you knew that they did in parliament.
No.
Why didn't you object to Bongo in the IEC yourselves?
No. They went through the IEC. Mm. And nobody said, by the way, there are these issues with 1, 2, 3, 4.
Yeah.
I'm stating facts here.
Mm.
On the basis of that, they are in parliament.
Mm.
When they are in parliament, now your reasoning is that when they are in parliament, having gone through these mechanisms
that's not all
and
that
these
matters.
Safeguards,
yes.
They must therefore not be chairpersons of committees. I'm saying your reasoning is not correct. It can't be correct. Maybe if they have done anything wrong in parliament, parliament must deal with them. And parliament, by the way,
what
still has...
Chief Whip, why was Bongo not dealt with? It was very clear. There was evidence, there were affidavits about that he tried to bribe an evidence leader. Why is he back in parliament? Why has he not been dealt with?
No. The matter in the fifth parliament was before the ethics committee of the fifth parliament.
Yes.
Whether it will be resurrected now in the sixth parliament, that's another matter. That is up to parliament.
Yeah.
Now, I can't get in there.
All right.
But it's a matter.
Okay, let's...
If for argument's sake,
yeah.
Comrade Bongo is found to have acted against the ethics as postulated in our ethics, in our code of ethics.
Yeah.
By the way, it's still not late to deal with Comrade Bongo.
Okay.
It's still not late. Right. It's still not late to deal with anybody,
yeah.
whether you're even a minister.
Yeah.
If you have breached the laws that govern conduct of any members of parliament,
yeah.
it's still not late if the relevant committee says, I can't see anything.
Yeah.
Whether you have now been promoted to be a chair, to be a whip, or to be a minister.
You have not escaped justice.
No, you have not escaped justice.
Yeah.
So, but it would be wrong to say that because we think justice is going to catch up with you, when justice has not caught up with you, therefore you cannot be a chair. That's all that I'm arguing.
You know, one of the things that was
discussed... That's all that I'm arguing.
All right. One of the things that was discussed in Mangaung, it fits in nicely in what you are talking about now.
Yeah.
Right? And that actually does what gave birth to the Integrity Committee that you are praising so much tonight. Right? To say that comrades who have serious allegations hanging over their heads must learn to step aside.
Yep.
I don't think that culture is taking root.
Well, I don't think that all of us who are public reps, not only in parliament, but everywhere else, even in legislatures or even in at local level, I don't think that we have basically made that culture part of our DNA.
Internalized.
We have not internalized it.
Okay.
It has not become what we thought it would be. You know, when we're discussing those issues, we thought that Mthembu will say, "Yeah, Baget, you can send everybody to parliament, but not me.
Yeah.
Because I'll just be an embarrassment to you when I'm there. I have these issues." Then even go to the Integrity Commission.
Yeah.
That was our thing.
That's why it was a surprise that on the eve of swearing in, the deputy president said, "Hey, man, I'm not swearing in. I'm going to the commission first."
Which was good.
To clear my name, but. But do you think that it's a good thing that that was an exception? That's supposed to be the rule, that everybody must be able to subject themselves when there's a question mark of one sort or another to this Integrity Commission that was set up in fanfare in Mangaung.
No, we agree. I'm saying the deputy president did a good thing.
Mm.
Now, if all of us, if we can just breathe that spirit of him
into everybody else,
we can be the best, not only in South Africa or in the continent, we can be the best in the world.
Yeah.
Where all of us can say, "Hey, Baget, you man. Ngathi kunengxaki apha
ensafuna
ukuyoyilungisa. Kunomcimbi ensafuna. Before you swear in,
awuthi
ndilungise lo mcimbi," which the deputy president did.
Yeah.
And
it's interesting that everybody seems to have passed the Integrity Committee test after that. So the deputy president went, the Integrity Committee interviewed everybody else, and nobody failed the test. It's very strange.
Well, you must call the Integrity Committee. You see, I'm not part of the Integrity Committee. You are speaking to a wrong person.
Yeah.
Call the Integrity Commission. Isn't it you can call them?
All right.
Call the Integrity Commission. Let them come here. Then you can pose those questions to them.
I'm going to take a break. After the break, I want to ask you a question about, have we learned anything from the Fifth Parliament in as far as dealing with the public protector's recommendations and reports? We're talking to Jackson Mthembu, minister in the presidency, pulling absolutely no punches left, right, and center. And tonight, he's going to tell us whether the new dawn, is taking off or it's being stalled. Let's take